Hey there friends, what's going on? It's Kodiak here and welcome back to another Biomutant Survival Guide video. Today we're talking about cashola, also known as green in the Biomutant universe. Now of course we're talking about an open world game here, which means you're gonna need a lot of money. And in Biomutant, that means money to buy mounts and weapons and gear and even consumables. To be honest, there aren't a whole lot of different ways to make green in the game, but we wanted to have one video on the channel breaking down all of them, including one of our favorite methods, so that you guys had the information you need while you're progressing in the game. Now, of course, the first way to make green is by finding green ATMs, and for whatever reason, that is what these things are called, ATMs. It completely threw us for a loop the first time we saw them in an area, but these are pretty simple. You'll see the hoop-like structure out in the world, jump through it, and you'll gain about 350 green each time. They are all over the map, so just keep your eyes peeled and you will be able to pick up a decent amount of money. The second method is the most tried and true way to make any sort of currency in any sort of open world game, and it of course has to do with your loot. As always, loot everything under the sun, and through your adventures, you will most likely pick up a number of miscellaneous items, which don't have any real practical application in the game, but can be scrapped or sold for a decent amount of green. Be sure before you sell any of these miscellaneous items to inspect them to see their scrap value. If you're hard-pressed for resources for crafting, you may want to do this instead of selling, but it's a balancing act. Because you're looting everything under the sun, you're most likely going to have some really valuable gear in your inventory. And this is by far the most lucrative way of actually making green in the game, selling off gear that you're just never going to use. Don't forget about those upgrade benches either. You can take any piece of gear in the game, and with enough upgrades, bring it in line with your progression. So just make sure before you sell something, you really want to sell it. We also want to remind you that if an item has a high sell value, it's because it has a lot of valuable components. Make sure to inspect any items that you guys want to sell, check out all of the different components that are made up in that item, and consider dismantling it to get those components back. You can always sell bits and pieces of items if you want certain components later down the line for crafting. Now you can also sell consumables in the game. Pretty much anything that you find, you can sell. And what we like to sell are those supercharged consumables that imbue your weapon with elemental damage. To be honest, Livid and myself barely use these during our progression, and they sell for a decent amount of green. So if you pick up a lot of them, we're talking thousands upon thousands of currency, and that is easy money right there. The final and easily our favorite method in the game for making green is by collecting pearls in the Surf Repelagos. These can sell for 500 plus green, and if you find the right vendor, you can sell them for thousands. These are scattered all around the Surf Repelago beaches, so take a nice walk on the beach, take out your Google Eye, and go make some green. Finally, we'd be remiss if we didn't talk about barter and charisma. The higher your charisma, the lower prices will be when you buy items, and that just means you'll need less green. But honestly, with the tips and tricks we've talked about in this video, the different methods that we've found to be effective, you're gonna have plenty of green. You're pretty much gonna be able to buy any mount, any item in the game. And honestly, that pearl tip, that is the money maker, because you can make thousands upon thousands of green with very little ease. Put on some music, put on a video, go on the beach. I mean, there is no better strategy than that. And as is often the case in video games, combining all of the different methods is going to get you that windfall that you're after, which means more mounts, more items, more weapons, more everything. As always, guys, we're not here to stretch out a 5-minute video into a 10-minute video, and if you appreciate brevity, we would appreciate your support. Hit that thumbs up, and of course, subscribe to the channel for more Biomutant content in your feeds. We also invite you to join us on Discord. We've got a great community of nearly 7,000 members spread across dozens of great games, with a special section dedicated just for Biomutant, so check out the link in the description below to join today. Finally, if you guys like our channel and you want to support Legacy Gaming even more, you can now do so by becoming a member. For the cost of a cup of coffee, you're helping evolve the channel and take our community to that next level. Check out the join button below to learn more. My name is Kodiak, and from everyone here at Legacy Gaming, thanks for watching, and play on.